Today on the show, we're going to be talking about characters as avatars for bettering ourselves as people. So you probably hear it all the time. Superman is an avatar for hope. Spider-Man is an avatar for the average person. And a lot of people hear this and they go, yeah, Superman's an avatar. But they don't really take on what that means. There is a quote by Grant Morrison that kind of relates to this topic. And it goes something along the lines of, before the bomb was a bomb, it was an idea. So instead of having an idea that causes destruction, why don't you have a better idea instead? For the past year and a half, I've really been meditating on that quote and living my life by it. And as such, I think my life has improved a lot. Let's take Flex Mentallo for example. His character is an avatar for the search for the truth. In his comic, he is after a guy called The Fact. Flex Mentallo is after the fact of the truth. In his comic, we see Flex go through the physical manifestations of the stages of life, and at the end of the comic, we learn to choose love over fear. I've actually done a Flex Mentallo video, so if you want more information on it, please click the link down below. But the bigger question here is, how does Flex Mentallo affect us in our everyday life? Now let me use my own life as an example for all of you. Now I've been reading comics for as long as I can remember. And when I was young, I used to select a few characters here and there and they were really my role models. But at this point in my life, I have a whole range of characters that I look to not only make myself happier, but to better myself as a person. Now I didn't have the happiest of teenage years. I used to self-harm a lot. I attempted suicide a number of times, and I'm only here right now because of two reasons. One, because I knew I had to better myself as a person to get through all of this. And number two, I have the best parents in the world. I didn't have the ability to go to a therapist for help, and I didn't have it in me to go to someone in my family for help. I had comics. And there are three comics that really made me realize I'm worth something and life is worth living. There's Flex Mentallo, the Man of Muscle Mystery, which really taught me to choose love over fear. And then there's Death, the High Cost of Living. Now, Death as a character is really an avatar for death as a release of life. How when you die, you will be at peace. You've got nothing to be afraid of. But in Death, the High Cost of Living, the message in that is really, you're not here for long. So make your time here worth it. And the third comic in this list might surprise some of you, but it's actually the 90s Impulse series. I always say I relate to Tim Drake and Wiccan more than any other comic book character. And that's true because like Tim Drake, Impulse is a great friend to me. Impulse is really the avatar for happiness and being yourself. And you can either teach people to appreciate you for you, or you can forget about them. Then when Tim Drake, Impulse, and Superboy came together and created Young Justice, they became the collective avatar for the fact that you are always loved. Even if you don't know it, there is always someone who cares about you. Now I do just want to take this moment to say that if you are depressed and you can go and get help, please go and get help. Now what about comic book characters we don't like? Because they're just as valuable as the ones we do like. You see, people tend to hate comic book characters that they share negative attributes with. Now, it's good to read about these characters so you can see these negative attributes in action, see how they get around them, and then apply that to your own life. So who don't I like? I don't like Wolverine. Wolverine is really an avatar for perseverance and never giving up, which is a side of him I really like. But the part of him I don't like is his short temper. You might not know this about me because I really try not to come across as this on camera, but I'm really a short-tempered person. It really doesn't take much to make me angry, and it doesn't take much to put me in a bad mood. This is something I've only recently realized about myself, and I'm pretty sure it's the reason why I stopped enjoying the Wolverine and the X-Men series, because I just saw that anger too much in myself. So how can I get around these feelings of anger that I have? Well, I can either look for a character that doesn't really get angry, or look for a character that has learned to control their anger. Raven from the Teen Titans from a very young age had to learn to control all of her emotions, so she would be a very obvious choice. However, how she controls her emotions isn't exactly healthy, and I really don't want to bring that upon myself, so I need to search for a different option. Generally, I find the most uncommon answer is the best one for myself. So my answer to this question is Harley Quinn. Harley Quinn is who I'm going to use to get around my anger. Now, Harley Quinn doesn't really get angry all that often. She's usually as loopy as a box of frogs. But when she does get angry, it's to utilize her anger in a situation that will help her achieve what she wants to do. I'm a person that wants to achieve a lot with their life. I have a lot of dreams and not much time to do it. So if I have to utilize my anger to achieve those dreams, then throw the rage at me. Like I said, Harley Quinn is as loopy as a box of frogs and lovable to the core, and she only gets angry when it's necessary. And that's kind of who I want to be. Now on to the last part of using comic book characters to better ourselves. Now, mental well-being is all well and good, and it's very, very important. But it's no good having a great mental well-being if you're physically unwell. This is where Tim Drake comes into my life. Tim Drake is really the person that I've been emulating most recently. You know, when he became Robin, he was fit, but he was nowhere near where Robin needed to be. Tim needed to be better than both Dick Grayson and Jason Todd, so Batman knew that Tim was not going to die, so he knew he could trust Tim, which meant Tim had to better himself physically and mentally. And that's something you don't really come by that often in comics. I'm at a stage in my life where I'm much better mentally than I have ever been, and lots of people really say I am wise beyond my years in knowing myself, which I really do take as a compliment because I really feel like I know myself really well. However, physically, it's no secret, I'm unhappy. I've got extreme physical body issues, which is why I'm using Tim Drake as a way to improve myself physically. That is actually why I'm working on my Becoming Robin series, which is part fitness diary and part cosplay guide. And at the end of it, hopefully, we will make the ultimate Tim Drake cosplay. This series is going to be out in October, but for everyone that donates to me on my Patreon, you will get 1 month early access. I have linked my Patreon down below. So, what comics should you read if you want to better yourself? Well, I've already talked about Impulse, Flex Mentello, and Death, the High Cost of Living, and I definitely recommend all of those. Another two comics that I would recommend are Sex Criminals, which remind you that there is something special about everyone and you should never forget that, and Red Robin, which is really about discovering yourself while not forgetting who you used to be. And finally, my favorite series, which is jam-packed full of multiple messages in every single issue, is the Teen Titans. That shouldn't be a surprise to any of you because you all know I absolutely love the Teen Titans. But you can use this method with any works of fiction. It doesn't just have to be comics. You could use mythology. There is nothing stopping you. If you feel like you can better yourself from reading it and experiencing it, go for it. Comic Book Girl 19 just did a TED talk with a very similar subject, which I have linked down below because her way of speaking about this might help you a lot more than my way. I have also linked my comic shop links down below to all the comics that I have mentioned in this video. I would also recommend you watch Grant Morrison Talking with Gods and read Super Gods by Grant Morrison. Finally, I just wanted to say that I'm sorry this video wasn't as big or as crazy as usual. I had a very emotionally draining weekend and I really just didn't have the chance to write a big video. But I'm hoping this very personal video will help all of you and serve to entertain all of you. Okay guys, that is it for today. Who is a character that you can use to better yourself? Please let me know in the comments down below. And also don't forget to support the show by checking out my Patreon, like me on Facebook, follow me on Twitter, and subscribe to my gaming channel. My name is Faust, this has been Exploring Comics, and it is super effective.